guys, so this is the piece that we're going to accomplish today, and I've just peeled back everything and double checking it has not gone through to the other side. I do demonstrate in this video how we're going to mask up the piece of paper and how to prevent your watercolor paints and etc. from going through to the other side. So this is the final piece and I hope you guys enjoyed. I did use a range of new products today. One is the Fine Tech Pearl Colors. Two is the Mission Gold, the Mission Gold 24 pan palette here. I did use Posca pens and I did use the Faber-Castell watercolor pencils. I did a range of masking as well, using some big sheets of card to protect the paper from bleeding through and seeping through the spine. So just so you know, that is what we're using today. So if you're interested in creating this, please follow along with the tutorial, or the, I guess, follow along. This type of painting though, or artwork, isn't something that you can recreate exactly, but you can definitely create something really similar with the color choices and the paints and the products that I'm using today. So definitely yours will be unique, but this is my rendition of it today. So I hope you guys will enjoy, and I'll see you guys next time. Hi everyone, it's Tao from Shine Bright Design, and today, well not today, for the next couple of weeks, it's going to be watercolor weeks. Or watercolor week, I don't know, I guess. We're doing watercolor for my own personal tutorials, basically. Why? Because I feel like I need to get back into the watercolor medium. Now, we're going to do this piece from Hannah Carlson's book, Summer Nights, which is Summer Nights. I love it in the Swedish version. I love books, like her books, when they're not in the English version. I think it gives it a bit of character. I don't know, I'm Australian, my English is my first language, and it's so like mundane to me, and I love, like, I love the fact that I have a book that's in another language. It just gives it so much more character. Even with the new one, Magical Dawn, I would prefer it in the Swedish version as well, just because I feel like it gives it character, you know? Okay, what I'm doing is, I want to protect the back of this book. So what I'm going to do is, I got a piece of like watercolor paper in behind it, and I'm basically masking it up. This will prevent any bleed through and getting that paint on the back. Hopefully this turns out well, because I do like the picture on the back too. I've done this before. It's not going to bleed through. It's fine. And if it does, cry me river. I will tell you. I will tell you again if it does. I'll probably throw in a like little video before this, just to give you like a feedback of how it went and the outcome. Okay, so what I'm also going to do is I'm going to mask up the spine here. I'm just going to take some care. Now, you're going to ask me why am I doing this, and basically it's because when you're working with these books, when you're using watercolor in any coloring book, for example this one, because the way the binding's done, the watercolor paint is going to seep through the binding and potentially the paint would go through the spine. Now, I've done it in the past here and luckily enough it hasn't gone through, but that's because when I'm working with backgrounds for coloring, I'm very quick. But this, I'm doing the whole thing in watercolor, so that's why I want to mask it up properly. So this is how you mask it up, and this is watercolor week. So I hope you guys enjoy. I'll do a little bit of a video before this introduction, giving you feedback on how I felt it went. And yeah, so what I'm working with today is a bunch of things. I haven't practiced using some of these products, but today it's an experiment, and I hope you come along for the journey. So, what I have is the Magello Pure, the Magello Mission Gold set. This is a 24 pan. I could use my Pure Pigment set, but I feel like I'm gonna keep it a little bit on the cheaper side, I guess. Not really cheap products, but you know, I'm hoping some of you guys have this. And if you don't want to use the watercolor aspect, I am using the Faber-Castell watercolor pencil set in the 120. Now, if you don't like that it's watercolor, what you can do is still use the same colors in the Polychromos range. It just means that you won't have the watercolor texture. But if you're liking the colors and the rendering aspect, feel free to use it. But I don't know how this is gonna go, so I hope you follow along and enjoy. All right, so what I always do with watercolor pencils, watercolor, is I do washes. Now, what I have here is two jars, or two whatever. One is full of, I guess, clean water, and the other one is clean, but it will be my dirty jar. You can tell because the jar's not really that clean. And then I also have my watercolor set here on the side, which I will show you guys.
We are working with this set, the watercolor Faber-Castell set. This is the 120 range. I have done an, I don't think I did an unboxing of this, but I did receive this for my birthday last year. I haven't had the chance to use it. I only used it really slightly, and today we are going to use it, hopefully properly. But we'll see how we go. It is watercolor week, or watercolor month. I don't know. We're doing watercolor for a few weeks. If you guys enjoy, I just want to see if you guys enjoy it and if you guys are liking it.
So it has been, or else I'll just switch back to Polychromos and watercolor painting, you know, the normal paper. And I really miss it, you know. I think I kind of stepped away from it because, one, I noticed that you guys weren't really enjoying the watercolor paintings, and I think some of you guys liked it when I used the watercolor in the Bloomster Mandala. It wasn't really a tutorial though, it was more like a time lapse. But yeah, it didn't really look like it was doing well, and I kind of had to step away from it. And I kind of want to get back into it because I feel like I always say, it's always important to step outside the box once in a while, because you know, you don't want to become, I guess, too blocked in your medium. Now, so I have all my brushes, my waters, my paints, my watercolor pencils, and what I love the most is my paper towel. Paper towel is always handy. And I also need another piece of paper. Sorry if that was really loud. I'm just rolling all over the place. Now, this is just normal card. I might also tape this to the spine, just to keep it safe. Because I guess I don't want paint on the other page either. Okay, alright. We are masked up and we are ready. That is how you prep a page when you're doing watercolor paintings. So, for example, if you are doing watercolor backgrounds with me, mask the page. Mask the back of the page. So the easiest thing for you to do is put paper on the back and then do the background. And this saves the paint going on the opposite side of the page. And it reduces any damage, and then you can still use the other page on the back. If you get what I'm saying. Okay. So I want to do a wash. And I'm trying to discover these colors again. Ah, okay. So what I want to do is, I might zoom in so you can see. I'm gonna do a close up of these flowers and work so that you can see what I'm doing close up. So, because the pages are thick, right? But they're not that thick, and this isn't watercolor paper, so don't drench it. So I'm just going to do a quick wash of one of these petals. Remember, I'm just experimenting however this goes and just seeing what we shall do. Okay, I'm picking up. I might put the palette right next to here. I'm picking up. What color? Yes, this one. I will list it on the screen. Remember, I'm experimenting while I'm doing this with you guys, which is probably not the best thing to do when I'm teaching something, but you know, it's all a journey. I guess some of you guys call my work process videos, in a sense it is, and if you want to come along for the journey, then come along, you know. So what I'm noticing is the paint on the wet on wet technique is probably the best. It just looks the most effective. So what I'm doing is, one, I'm doing a wash, and two, I drag the pigment on the darker side of the petal, and I let it bleed across. And then I grab my brush and I dab it on my paper towel to absorb any excess. And this is why you want clean water, because when you do the wash, it should be in clean water. And that way, when you apply the pigment, it's a clean contaminate. It's clean, it's not uncontaminated. You know what I'm saying? It's not contaminated, yes. It's probably not the best brush. I really need to get more paint brushes, like really nice mop brushes. Hopefully in screw hair, but it's so expensive. One brush is like $30 to $50 a brush. It's tiny. But I guess like a lot of painters, you only need one brush. That's the amazing thing about painting. Or watercolor painting. I'm going to have to change brush. This type of brush, I'm not having enough control, and it's because it's a longer brush. It's not really appropriate for what we're doing today. So I am going to change it into my little trinkets of paintbrushes. I don't have that many nice paintbrushes. I really should invest in some, but I really have been investing all my money in like coloring pencils and stuff lately, which is bad. I'd like to know what you guys are using, the majority of you guys, when you're watching my tutorials. Are you using Copic markers? Are you using Prismacolor pencils, Faber-Castells? If I can find out what a majority of you are using, then it will help me decide what mediums I should be including in my tutorials. Because sometimes I do include, I guess, the odd things such as Copic markers or pen pastels. And I know a lot of you guys don't have that, and when you're recreating or following a tutorial, if you don't have all the equipment, it makes it very hard for you to follow along. And yeah, I do understand that. So tell me guys below in the comment section what you guys are using. And I'll follow what the majority is using, definitely. This is a better brush. This is a very cheap brush though. This is like Montmartre, which is a very, it's like a dollar store paintbrush. And it's just one of their watercolor brushes. I wish I could get some really nice watercolor brushes, but you know, I had on my birthday wish list, I wanted these, I forgot they were called, but they were these three set of watercolor brushes, and there was only three, and they cost so much, like over $200 or over $200 just for three. It was ridiculous. Yeah, this brush is a lot better. The good thing about watercolor is that you can build up the pigmentation. So what I'm noticing is this is perfect pigmentation, but this is probably too faint. So I'm just gonna add a bit more pigment and blend it out. And the best way to blend it out is to water down your paintbrush. But see how quick this paper does dry? You can just see that it just dries very quickly. So you definitely can work in a lot of layers. And if it came to, I say, like, you're going to do watercolor pencils in this, I believe you could do it, as long as you don't drench the paper. Like the way I'm painting, I'm not drenching the paper at all. I've been so busy all today. I'm just like, I try not to rush work for like rush my art, but I just have so much to do. And I love creating for you guys, you know? It's just hard when you have a real, well, not a real job, but like when you have another job and you're doing YouTube too. This is my passion work, and my dream is that one day my passions will become my work. If you get me. I hear so many dream stories of YouTube artists becoming full-time YouTube artists. You know? Even if I wasn't a YouTube artist, I feel like I would still be doing this stuff. It keeps me happy, you know? Definitely doesn't put, you know, food on the table, but it gets me somewhere. You know, the horrible thing that, not horrible, but the unfortunate thing that happened in the recent week was that we in Australia had a ridiculous hot day in Sydney, especially like 40 degrees. It was ridiculous. Oh my God. Like, I was in the. Excuse me. I was in Sydney and it was just so hot. But, and we were so busy. By the time we got to the beach, it stopped being sunny as well. Started sprinkling. It was such a fail of a weekend, but you know. Please excuse that noise. Continuing, I picked up Crimson Lake. Is it Crimson Lake I'm picking up? I gotta figure out what colours these are. Clear, Crimson Lake, Permit. Okay. Yes. So I'm using Crimson Lake, and that's the colour I have been using this whole time. Crimson Lake, I guess, is one of the prettier colours of this palette. It's probably my go-to colour when it comes to anything. In with my Crimson Lake. I'm so busy, I've only had time to just film footage. I haven't had time to edit or anything. Hopefully I can get stuff out by the week. The sad thing is that I'm always traveling because of work, as in like I'm always up and down the coast. And it's really hard for me to like be in one spot at a time editing. Also, because my videos are humongous, like humongous large, you know. I try my best. A lot of people question why I do this, but I do it because I love it, and I love that you guys are enjoying it. Yeah. A lot of people in this world don't get to do what they love, and I'm fortunate enough to. I've been considering doing a few things with my channel, and one is, do I vlog during the month? So I do like a monthly vlog where I'm like talking about all the highlights of my month, or do I not? I don't know, because I kind of do that through these tutorials. We kind of have a chit chat, what's been going on, etc, etc. Because I don't know, you guys never really ask me questions about myself and who I am. Maybe because I tell you guys everything, I don't know. But yeah, I guess it's something that I've been considering. Don't know, it is something that I will explore. Repeating what I discussed before, just a nice clean wash. We'll probably do one petal at a time. It's probably the smartest thing to do as well. Pigment, let it bleed out. And then using your brush to just maneuver it through. Now, there's too much water, just use your brush to suck it up. So what I like to do is, wherever I like to keep dark, I kind of use the fat part here, because this is the cleanest, this would be the cleanest part of the brush, because it doesn't pick up the most pigment. Most pigment would be at the tip, and that's why where I want it dark, I maneuver the tip. And again, clean brush. Well, this is sort of clean, I guess. It's starting to get dirty. Doing a wash. Picking up your Crimson Lake. I'm using the tip where it would be the darkest. Let me dab my pigment a little on my paper towel. Now, as you can see, seems like it's too Crimson Lakey, as in like that's the main pigment here. So I'm going to mix it with another color, and this color is this color is Crimson Lake. This color is Permanent Magenta. Sorry guys. Don't worry, we can fix it. If you've been following along, we will fix this. I really need to do a swatch of that one. Yeah, okay, that's fine. So I went in with the Crimson Lake on top of the Permanent Magenta. No, leaving it out. I'll probably only do a tutorial of this, I reckon. Not a tutorial, but a time lapse of this, I reckon. So that's one flower. I know what I'm going to do. If you have been following my channel for a while, you know that things always progress and develop over time. I guess evolve. And I know what we're gonna do. We are going to create galaxy flowers, if that's such a thing. But we're going to give it a galaxy theme. I love it when things just like happen. That's real art, I tell you there. That is real art. When things just happen, when things just evolve, that is the power of art. When you control things too much, it's not as magical, I feel. When things just happen, it's like, ooh, you know. It's like, can only happen once, if you get what I'm saying. So the colours that I have used in this flower are Crimson Lake, Permanent Magenta and Peacock Blue. The good thing about Magello that I noticed is that the colours that they have in their palettes really work well together. They they complement each other very well. And I believe it's because just the pigments that I use, just the combinations, it just works. Like in this palette, there is no, I think there's no crimson red or cardium. There's no cardium in this palette, I think. Or maybe there is. Yes, there is no cardium. Cadmium? There's no cadmium in these palettes for some reason. It's very interesting, but yeah. Now, because we're doing a galaxy theme, what we must do is that I must start with a peacock blue, because that's like the nicest color. It's like the color you want to keep clean. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a wash of the peacock blue, and then we'll go in with the other colors. Not even that, let's not do a wash. Let's just do just a bleed, all right? We'll just go over everything, do washes of different light gradients of the pigment. And how you would do any other galaxy, you would do the same to this. I feel like this flower may evolve a lot better than this one. And what you need to do is keep it wet. Not soak it, but just keep your eye on things so that that you can keep working into it with the other colors. See how interesting that is? Just with the watercolor. Just that color is interesting. We're gonna go in with the permanent magenta. See how this turns out with the peacock blue. I'm just gonna dab it in. See how it bleeds, just to see how it like works with this combination and this, I guess, technique. So still, since we put that loose layer with the peacock blue, that's fine. But now that you're putting the magenta, you need to stick within the shapes of the flower and not do that loose fluid application like you did with the peacock blue. Whatever you apply within those shapes should stay in those shapes. Don't let it go into the other shapes. We still want it to be relevant that it's a petal. I guess what we're trying to do is we're using these colors that kind of are relevant within lots of galaxy paintings that I see online. And we're just gonna try and recreate that, but on the flower petal. I find this so interesting. See, I'm noticing a lot of the pages already drying. So, working with that water, I'm gonna try and re-wet. The reason why I want to do this is because I typically want the paints to bleed into each other, to give it that really interesting effect. I'm also doing some dry on dry technique as well, just to see how this goes. We'll let that dry. Get a bit more peacock blue and work it into this. I also don't want to put too much pigment on, like, I don't want to get muddy, and sometimes that can happen. Interesting. Okay. Let's move on. I want to pick up some watercolor pencils, and I'm picking up magenta. So let's just work with the diamonds and see how that goes. I don't mind that. Kind of hesitant of this piece right now. I don't know how it will turn out. I'm hoping that the artist in me will kick in and be like, bam, this is what we're gonna do. Fingers crossed. Thank you. So I've done all the watercolor pencil base for these diamonds. Oops, let me just readjust that. I'll probably just zoom out a little. Now I'm just gonna paint it with a little. Amazing watercolor pigment with these papers, or with these pencils. I am not surprised at all because these are Faber-Castell's. Lovely. So as you can see, I'm going over with the white watercolor pencil. Just to lighten up the color of magenta that we laid down as a base. In a sense, you are burnishing, but this is water soluble. That's the type of application I'm applying. So then I'm going back in with the magenta and creating that shadow. And I'm going to create like a boxing shadow. So we're just going to go harder at the edges or the lines. And then as we go into the center, we're just going to lift our application. Now we're not going to apply water to this layer either. We're just going to gradate it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back in to these flowers with the white on top of the paint, and I guess we're going to just rework what we've laid. I really want to have that star, I guess, galaxy effect, and I'm just going to stress to the point that I really want to have that proper texture, that galaxy-like texture. I love how it's developing right now. When you're working on top of these with watercolor pencil, it almost feels like it's pastel, but it's not. Just the way that it's sitting on top of the watercolor paint, it just looks very nice. I love it. And I think it's because I'm also using a lighter color as well. So like the pigments underneath are still coming through from the white. That's one of the nice things about using this medium. Obviously the white isn't that opaque, but it's still making it very lovely. I'm gonna try and catch the other one as well. Pulling it back. Alright. So this is the base and this is how I dry it, right? Sorry. That was my phone. I'm going in with the white into this one. It will be a bit different because this flower was a lot darker, this one wasn't. And we're just going to go in with the white just to see what type of effects that we can obtain. Going in with this white just to see if we can create some interesting textures. So I've gone in with the white. I'm actually going to go in with another color. This one is called Crimson, which is 1, 3, 4. This is a very interesting color. It doesn't look like crimson, but I'm assuming when we apply the color, it will come out that way. I'm going to pick up some Palfoy Blue and I'm going to run a little in as well. I'm going to go in with a darker colour, and that colour is Blue Violet, and that is 137. And I'm just going to place this colour in the folds of the flowers. That is looking really nice. I'm liking how that's developing. In order for me to get this rolling, I guess get some type of like structure, I need to do the background in order to do all the details. So what I'm gonna do first is do this thing, which is green. And I'm picking up this yellow green. And I'm basically going to do a wash. We're going to keep this really simple and magical today. I don't know why, but I'm not feeling it, but we can try. I can try and like make this work for me. I just feel like it's not there. I'll get it there. Don't you worry. I'm going in with this bright clear violet. And I'm just randomly placing it in different areas of this piece. Going in with this ultramarine blue. I'm just placing it also randomly. In terms of your painting, it will develop depending on you. It's all based on your mood, your application. But in terms of like the principle and the colors that we're using and what we're using, the idea is there. So you are welcome to come along. I just realized we haven't finished these diamonds, but we have finished these ones. But picking up the Palfoy blue, I'm also just placing it randomly. I'm just doing like a crisscross motion, letting the colors bleed together. You ask why I paint over those colors? Well, it's because I'm going to use some metallic pigments on top. So if you don't have metallic pigments, you can use Posca pens, you can use metallic markers, anything that sits on top. I just picked up a color called Rose Matter, and it is amazing. It is lovely. I'm liking it. Look at that. It's working really nicely in combinations with what we already have laid down. I'm going to bring in some peacock blue. I'm gonna let that dry and then we'll come back to it, see how it goes and see how it evolves. Okay, so I've scratched a couple balls here and laid on top of the flowers, and I got some white gouache that I've slightly diluted and something, and you can use a toothbrush, whatever. I'm just using an old bristle brush, and I'm just gonna flick some white stars. That's pretty cool. Add some more up here. So I blobbed on a bit too much, and we're just going to pick that up. This is messy stuff, so mind you, you should protect everything around you. So I did use like the paper towel. I'm gonna get a bit messy and just use my hands and just flick it on. I just feel like I got better control that way too. Okay. Very cool. But what I'm noticing as I'm doing this is that I'm just missing a bit of blue here. Let that dry. Moving on. So while I'm letting that dry, I'm just gonna get a Posca pen. A white one? Where is it? And I'm gonna go and outline these flowers. I'm gonna start off with this one. I'm basically gonna outline everything. I'm also feeling in the circles or the dots in the background with the Posca pen as well. You will see it becomes visible even though you have the watercolor paint on top. And then I'm going to do the other flower. And now I'm going to outline the diamonds.
Thank you.
Now we're going to do the green, and I'm going to do it quite dark. So I'm going to pick a color that has a bit of, I guess, like a blue tone, and this is deep cobalt green. Now cobalt is, I'm guessing, cobalt is blue, so it has like a blue tone green. So I'm going to use this color to create the shading. And I do realize this green, the yellow green that we placed down as part of the Mission Gold palette, is very light. So that's why I wanted this darker green, just to tone it back down. Alright, I'm going to move on to some fun things now. We You would have seen me use the Mission Gold Fine Tech palette last week in my Valentine's Day video. And today I'm going to use a similar palette, and this is the, what do we call this one? It's the Fine Tech Watercolor Pan Set. This is the Pearl Colors. I haven't had the chance to use this, and I've had this for like, I guess, maybe all, well, I got it in July last year in 2016. And I haven't had the chance to use it, and we are going to use it today. Now, the areas I want to use it are basically these little drop pearls. And I've been thinking about what color I want to use. And I think I'm going to use a shimmery pearl blue. So I'm assuming this color is a blue shimmer. Actually want something really opaque in a sense, so maybe that color isn't appropriate. I've been thinking about maybe a red or even a copper. I just want something to pop, really. I think this color will be most appropriate. So this is the Fine Tech Pearl Color Palette and the Watercolor Pan Set. I'm going to use this color here. This color is called Silver Pearl. Now I could use Silver Pearl or Blue Pearl. I might actually use a combination of the two. I might switch between the two and just see how it looks. I'm gonna zoom in so you can see. I just wanna see how opaque this is. It's actually quite opaque. I was actually scared that it wouldn't be opaque because it was watercolor based. Yeah, this is really, really nice. So I'm gonna stick with the blue pearl, and I might highlight with the silver pearl as well. So the best thing about this palette is you can just drop some water in the palette, like so. Where is it? And you just can make it really milky. Don't make it too thin. You need some thickness. Just enough to lay down the color. I don't want it too washed out. See, that's a bit washed out for me. And the reason I'm choosing these like pearlescent colors is because we are going with a galaxy theme, and I kind of wanted it to look almost like mystical in a sense. I didn't want it to look like it was solid or it was physically there. So I guess I went with a pearlescent color because it gave that kind of spacey, mystical feel. You get what I'm saying? I don't know, this is just what I feel. I don't want like a solid white or anything. I just wanted something shimmery. I guess it's just an excuse also to use stuff that I haven't had the chance to use. So I laid down that pearl blue. I'm gonna go in the silver and see if I can highlight, which I can, which is very cool.
It's not noticeable though. I think we're gonna do something else as well. We're gonna let all those little drop forms dry. I'm gonna zoom out. Just see how things look overall. That's pretty cool. I want to add some more oomph, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to do some speckles, like how we did with the white wash, but this time instead I'm going to pick up a bunch of pigment from this palette. So like that, and just flick. Okay, and also some gold. And then some green. And then some silver. Okay. So, I think we're good. Let me just sign it. And we're just gonna peel it off. Be careful though. Your masking tape may tear the paper. So go very slow. Oh, this is getting good. Again, peeling slowly. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Very good.
And lastly, look at that. That is amazing. Okay, this is the final piece. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this tutorial. Hopefully it's something that you can follow along, or it's just something that you can just watch as an abstract piece. I don't know how long it's taking me. I'm kind of lost on time right now. But I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.